Hi everyone, in this video, I'm going to show you how to assign individual Jamboard to your students so they don't edit your original copy. So there are two ways of doing this. The first way is to use the Google Classroom, and the second way is to force a copy. I'm going to show you how to do it on Google Classroom first. So as you see, I'm on my Google Classroom right now. And the first thing I'm going to do is go to classwork and then click add create. In here, I'm just gonna pick assignment. Okay, so now I'm in the edit mode of assignment. I'm going to add my Jamboard. So usually I already create my Jamboard or save my Jamboards from other people, and it will be already be saved in my Google Drive. So I just need to click add and then click Google Drive to retrieve my Jamboard. Okay, so now I can see that I have my Jamboard saved right here. So I'm going to just pick one of them. After I add this Jamboard, you can see here it says students can view file. To make sure students can actually answer on the Jamboard, you want to click this drop-down menu and then select make a copy for each student. That way, when you assign this Jamboard to the students through Google Classroom, each of them will have their own copy and they won't be editing other people's copy. And you just need to add your title. And you can also add instructions and change the points, due date, topic. So let's say I'm just gonna assign it right here. And I will show you what it looks like from the student's end. Okay, so now I'm on a student account and I already joined the same class. And you can see I just posted the new assignment for Jamboard. So I will go to classwork and then open this assignment. So in here, you see that I already have this Jamboard right here showing in the Your Work section. I just need to click it. And now it's open. I can read the direction given by my teacher. And then I just go to my next slide and I can drag right here based on the direction. The student can also draw on Jamboard. So you just need to teach them to go to the pen tool right here and select either a pen, a marker, or highlighter, or brush. So if I want to make my points more visible, usually I pick the highlighter and then just click white. And for example, if I want to draw the point 1, 4, I would go 1 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I just draw the point right here. Okay, so now I will show you the second method. First, you want to find your Jamboard in the Google Drive. So I will click the waffle icon here and then go to Drive. And in here, you should see the Jamboard that I already saved recently, or you can find it in your folder. So I'll open this one. And let's say I want to share this Jamboard to my students. I will go to the share button here, click it. And I want to just get a link for people to view. I don't need people to edit it since I don't want people to edit my original copy. So before you can copy link, you want to go to change here. Make sure it says viewer. And then you just copy the link. And then hit done. And the next thing you want to do is just open a new tab in Google Chrome. And then enter the link that you just copy. Here you will see it says google.com and then slash with a bunch of letters and numbers. You want to keep these, and after this there's another slash. So I would want to delete everything after this slash, basically starting from edit, and change everything to copy. And then I will copy this whole link. So to show you what it looks like, I'm going to open incognito window and just paste the link that I just copied. And this time I make it slash copy. So I'm going to enter. Okay, so now it asks me to sign in. So I just enter the Gmail and password of my student account and I'm going to click next. All right. So as you see, now it says copy document. Would you like to make a copy of this Jamboard? So I'm going to click make a copy. Now I get my own copy of the Jamboard, and it's not the original file from the teacher's Google Drive. It's now saved in my student's Google Drive. So as a teacher, you don't have to worry about the student editing your original Jamboard. After the students complete their work, they can share the link with you so that you can check their answer. To do so, it's pretty much the same thing. They just click the share button. And then they want to make sure you can edit it, so they want to change it to editor instead. And then they will copy this link and send it back to you. So this second method is good for teachers who don't use Google Classroom but still want to use the features of Jamboard. This is the end of the tutorial. I hope this is helpful for you. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Until next time!